सवितुर्वरेण्यम् भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्। सवितुर्वरेण्यम् भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्।
Okay, you all bow the flowers and namaskar and so on. That so we do the puja. I remember God and our deities, the Devi. Then we invoke them, the Pran Pratishtha, which we did the very first day too. And we bow, namaskar, pavitra, we purify, you know. And remember, jnanam, meditate, smaran, remember, jnanam, we focus. So now you all would want to, when you finish that, you want to offer water and so on. Right? Do you have dota that side? Do you want this one? Om Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu
Om Gamdacharya
Devotion, oh Mother, Divine Mother, we bow to you, O attendants of Mother Durga. Having performed puja and Ganesh, Gauri, Prithvi, Kalsa, Navgraha Deta, Deta Prata, Deta, Panchalupa, Dasadipal, Panchayatan, Panchadev Puja, Agni Devta Puja. Now we are doing this. Atra Shausat Yogini Mata Pujanam Hari Om. Flowers, yeah, flowers on the side of her. Pujartapatitam pushpam malam samarpayami akshatascha surashesh kumkumakta ashvishovita mayani dhyana parameshwarakshitam samarpayami harihi om.
Only for it,
yeah? Yeah, only for it. also put on the link now, I'll get you.
Like
Shakina.
Good job. Shiva Pago.
Thank you. Thank you.
Put down the paper, son. Please sit. That's the last belief. See if you want to hear. See if you want to hear. If you can't study, they stay. If you can't study, they stay. No, no, you feel it already. Just inside. You might have Shankara inside the Shilingam. Shankara inside the...
Yeah.
Right, you get it? Right, that's very good. Now you can do your RT. Lutata be stage for Ganesh and so on, and they move
Punja. Yeah, Baba.
Hello, you don't forget to take a little bit of this to put him on my doorway. A little bit and bring it back for me. Alright, you just put it and bring it back. This is for the Ganesh and Book. Got your fire ready, that's all. You want it for the fire? Start all your offering, you know, over again, like milk, water, you know, and then you go to cotton, just like we're doing with him all the time. Ram Ganapataye Namo Nama, Siddhi Vinayaka Namo Nama, Ashta Vinayaka Namo Nama, Ganapati Baba Moriya, Ganapati Baba Moriya, Ram Ganapataye Namo Nama, Ram Ganapataye Namo Nama, Siddhi Vinayaka Namo Nama, Ashta Vinayaka Namo Nama, Ganapati Baba Moriya. Right, so you are free to choose. Some use by the tusk, some use the end of the trunk with the two holes. Right? You offer your milk and water. Because you know an elephant can't pick up things like Moriya, 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 Ganapati Baba Moriya, Mangalamurti Moriya, Ganapati Baba Moriya, Mangalamurti Moriya. This is your beautiful emoji. They're looking like you made out a monster. Yeah, the way I painted and etc. That is Mahaganapati Devta. What do you have here? That's milk?
Yes.
And you offer water. Now here you don't have to offer incense. You have a tool incense light in here already. So we'll offer RT when you finish putting it in.
Look, you shouldn't use that.
What mixture do you have there? Devotees of God, please do not forget. Because remember, Katha went like this too. Is it last time? Like, you have to remember your do. Because do is important in Ganesh Puja. So that is why in that tree that you are drawn there, you see two strands of do.
Right?
At least take one strand and off.
In
that tree, I put two strands of do grass. One is for
here
and one
is
for here. In the same tree that you have there. Yigabhiganam kurumai deva sarvakaleshu sarvada Uvaktatunda mahakaya koti surya sambhava Yigabhiganam kurumai deva sarvakaleshu sarvada.
What do you want to see?
Gananantva Om Gananantva Ganapati Gunghava Mahe Priyanantva Priyapati Gunghavamahe Nidhinantva Nidhipati Gunghavamahe Vaso Mama Aham Jani Garbhadama Tram Jasi Garbhadama Sri Manmaha Ganathi Vatayi Namaha. send you a friend, or more talent, something, something. Now, don't forget, you only say the land is good, but don't forget you can put that from a clothing. Give that piece of the garden, I'd be happy to see. If you wish, but everybody end the offer one time, right? You
want the offer?
If you wish, you want to book puja and book park. Book come, and book. Sorry.
That is our place.
That is the case. Yeah.
I know, you want to get things done?
Om sumka se kadanta se kapil gaja karnaka lambo darasya bikta vinasa
naka guru krishna
Yeah. Cosa vuoi fare se la settimana? La settimana per la sessione di noi.
Yeah. And how when a
person becomes a stepmother or adopted mother, how much love will still come from that person by your example? But tonight, we see our child helps, unrelated, not biological, but it helps a mother. Mom, your child's vila is so wonderful. Tonight, as we enter into satsang, may you bless your children. The listen to the story and the glory of Ganesh Baba and to learn something. Keep in mind.
Om Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvani Sharanye Nayambike Dore Narayane Namostute Guru something that might hurt someone. You insult people sometimes. We all do.
We lose our temper sometimes. And things are uttered that really shouldn't be uttered. Language is used that shouldn't be used. Sometimes we do, physically, we do something. That if God could spin back this earth and give us a second chance to do it over, we'd do it differently. There are some people that feel guilt. They feel bad. But in the heart and mind of a person, sometimes this bad feeling, this guilt, is very secretive. Because in all fairness to everybody, who is going to come out and disclose to the world, I have done X and Y in my life, I've made this mistake, I've made that mistake in my marriage, I've made this mistake with my children, I've done this error in the course of my life. Who's going to do that? And in this world, we try to get people to realize and accept the fact that there's a weakness in their character. And sometimes they accept the fact that there is a weakness. That's the biggest step a person could achieve for you. But as a Hindu, there are some people that think, for some reason, I don't know, that God doesn't show mercy. He doesn't give a chance. When you do it, you pay for it. And at this point in our discourse, I want to ask a simple question as Hindu people. If God is simply recording our karma, action by action, deed by deed, and there is no mercy, there is no preparing it, then why bother praying? Why bother trying to achieve some grace or favor from God when you know what? My karma is already predestined. It is already written in stone that nothing I can do will change that. When you pay attention to your prayer, look at what you see. Think about it for a second and think and see what sometimes we say in prayer. Dear Lord, I'm sick right now. Could you please change my faith and make me healthy once again? Dear Lord, I only have $5 in my pocket. Could you please change my faith and put $50 somehow in my pocket? Dear Lord, I can't get a job. Dear Lord, I can't get a husband. Dear Lord, I'm grieving for a child. Could you please change my faith and give me what it is I would like to have? Suppose it was destined for you never to have children, never to get married, never to have these basic things. You see, many times people don't realize the power of your prayer and what that prayer signals to God. Your prayer is a tool that is used. Whenever you do puja, jap, charity, whatever it is a tool to change your faith. That you know what, I'm not happy with where I am now. In this life, I would like to get better. And after this life, I would like to find my Lord and Master. I don't want to come back. I don't want to have to go through another good cycle. I'm fed up this thing, trying to fight karma. I would like to go to God. This is the power of prayer. So as a Hindu now, when a person has made a mistake in all fairness, when a person is guilty, isn't there going to be some mechanism for forgiveness? If a person goes to jail for murder in the legal system, and the person reforms, they change their ways, they're released on good character. And likewise, when a person realizes, as we mentioned the other night, from very proud a person sees upon their body the scars of their past sins. The person who, for example, for those of you that missed it, the person that says, I saw you do the crime, but they are lying. Person who likes to say things, say they saw something, but it wasn't so. In the next life, the eyes, God takes away their function. The person who likes to listen to gossip, I love to hear juicy stories. In the next life, this is why God allows some people to be born deaf. I'm not saying it's a nice thing, but this is why God made all of us in His likeness, in perfection. This is why some people are born imperfect, because of our past deeds. And when a person realizes in this age, in this life, in this form, you know what, I got a chance,
I can be in the temple, I can be in prayer, I can ask for forgiveness for the mistakes that I have done before. This is how by good karma, good actions, good things to engage yourself in, good comfort, whatever you want to write. Of course you can reform and escape some of the mistakes, some of the karma, some of the punishment that we are about to engage in. From this perspective, what could happen? Why do you check Patra? As Hindu people, if my fate is written and inscribed in stone, why do you do Japa? What is the correlation? Tonight, you are here about the fellow who wrote the Patra. And he's very close to Ganesh Baba on this course tonight. And for the children here, in this discourse, we're going to talk about how Ganesh Baba got that little fellow over there. Many people don't know how he got that little rabbit as well. On this course deals with the history of that little horse. So we have another thing to talk about. And somebody asked me, I see Ganesh Chowd, I see Ganesh Chowd, Chowd after Chowd, where are we going to need him to carry? Is there a mean or a mode or a modus to do Ganesh Chowd Puja? What is the benefit of Ganesh Chowd Puja? What could a person derive and how to get that blessing? Tonight you will see our little mouse. He leads by example and he does Ganesh Chowd Puja. And we'll go from Master Puran where I'm starting my katha. I will jump in the Ganesh Puran, and here, as the monk moves, as the child moves, there's a different way to offer that prayer in Ganesh Puran. So I will get various types of blessing. Some people did say they will walk with their pen and paper. Trust me, tonight I'm not going to waste your time. You will have the information that you deserve. And somewhere in the Puran, you will have to sing a song for me. So, let's get started. Is you ready? Chris, you ready? Okay. Let's sing our song to Ganesh right now. And then we will go into our discourse.
Gopala Oh,
should run, where you will find the history of this mosque. Narad Muni is listening to Lord Vishnu. And strangely enough, he had just listened. So Katara deals with Lord Ganesh on a lion. There are different forms, many different forms of Ganesh Prabhu. In different forms, he is seen riding a tiger, a lion. In some, he is on a horse. In some, he is on Hanuman Bhava. Different forms, taken from different discourses. We in Trinidad are very accustomed to the Janan form, which is on the horse. Narad Muni says, Prabhu, with all respect to Ganesh Ji, he has a wonderful form. He has a huge form. He is very powerful. But Mahavishnu, his Vahan, doesn't suit his form. Will you please tell me the history, the reason why this form is so small, why a mouse, of all the creatures, of all the different animals, his brother has a wonderful form, a Vahan. That peacock is very rapid, very swift. What is the benefit of the mouse? Why did he choose that? Prabhu, this is my next question. May you please tell this thing. May you please give to me the reason and the rationale behind this one. Mahavishnu, knowing that Narad, his questions have never ended. But whatever he never asks questions that are selfish, he never asks questions that are foolish. But he asks questions that will benefit the person that listens. So he says, there are some, the question that you ask is very good. Many people will learn something out of it. He says, please listen. Yeah, everybody, let's all join together as we go into this course tonight.
जय भोले बाबा तब शरणा
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 जय
Jai 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 Jai
at one point in the heavenly region, there was a separate zone. And in this separate zone, much singing, much dancing, much merriment was taking place. And at one point in the order of things, a group of dancers came, and all the uplifted souls, all the planets are gathered in the order of nature. And when this dance was taking place, one of the dancers made a mistake. One fella by the name of Prongsha, he missteps in his movement. And not only does he break the pattern of the dance, the sway of the dance, and as a result breaking the message of the dance. Because dancers, they portray a message with the movement and the sway of their body. So he disrupts that message. Not only does he do that, but he takes with the foam press that he's hitting the floor, and he hits the feet of Vamadeva Muni. He damages this Muni's foot. And without a second thought, without thinking with compassion, Vamadeva Muni, his temper, flares. And he puts wrath on Prongsha that you will be unworthy, you will take the form of a huge rat. Because of this mistake, you are like a pest, become a pest, and convert him from that human, beautiful form that you have. As a stage performer, his physique is perfect, his form is graceful, but as fate would have it, he made a mistake. And at the mercy of this Muni, he now takes his huge form. It is said his head extended high into the heavenly region. Not this little form that we have here. Very huge. And Vamadeva tells him, you leave from this place. Don't stay here. Pests and the life form that you are now part of, they are not welcome. Because of disease, because of the pestilence, because of the mold, the sickness and the trouble they cause, they are not welcome in company. May you go upon the earth and be chased in the same way I am chasing you now. Be hunted, be hated the same way I feel animosity towards you right now because of what you did. Because of the pain you've caused me in this moment, for the rest of your existence, you will be in pain. You will be separated. People will have pets, people will have love for animals, but no love will be shown to you. No one will accept you. Go and live the life of an outcast. And in this huge form of the breath, Prongsha falls into the ashram from heaven. He comes down into the ashram of Parashat Muni. Parashat Muni is very significant to our current day books and so on. And at that moment, he was writing a very important book. And Ganesh Baba was being the editor. He was listening and he was critiquing the book that Parashat Muni was writing. And in this conversation, Prongsha comes and falls into the ashram and causes havoc. Everybody is seeing this region, this huge form. So you must have yourself a huge rat, towering one or two stories higher. What will you do? All the children, all the different tenants in that ashram, they forget prayers, they forget seva, and they start to run helter-skelter. And because of his size, poor Prongsha, in this form, he can no longer have that beautiful physique, small stomach and small appetite. Now he's ruled by instinct. Now he's ruled by hormones. And as an animal, when he started to smell the food in the ashram, the stockpile of grains, he started to attack with full ferocity. With full force, he started to knock against the walls to get to the food that he's eating very greedily. Rashid Muni, hearing the crying and the stress call of all those younger ones around, it pains him to break that conversation with the Islam because of the work that he's doing. But sometimes, as Rabish is in it in Arab, sometimes as you make up your mind, as you make the resolution to do something, that is the moment test will come. He says that's the moment difficult to come. That was the moment distraction will come. And it's the hope of our single Lord and Master to see what you will do. For Rajan Muni is engaged in the very, very critical move. But when he is called away, for Rajan Muni gets up and he rushes up. For the better understanding of the severity of what is going to happen, please understand what Rashid Muni was doing. Let's hear in this
story. Narayana Krishnaya
children born, what time help children we have, straight up to, I'm sick, I don't want to die, I don't want to die. It's not free to do, to perform, to prevent untimely death. So Russian money, current money, and other monies, they started rather targeting this information. And they took all this information, huge book, and they brought up Lakshmi Mata. And they said, Mother, may you touch this book. May you be the editor and allow this book to be as a religious book, because it will bring a lot of help to the human race. And they thought, they swore, they thought to themselves, they were very confident that they would be good. Lakshmi Mata turns around and she says, this book is true. Do not endorse this book. This book will prolong the lives of people that are sinful. If the wrong person should get this book, this information, it will cause trouble on the face of this student. Therefore, I don't endorse this book. In fact, I don't want this book to be a religious book. They all bare their heads in defeat. There's no arguing that's remembered. And they leave. But Parashat Muni and Garg Muni, these two are very adamant. And they took all the different knowledge from the different monies that had given up and left. And they started to concise this information. This book that the both of them worked upon is what we call today the Patra. And in there are different ways, there are different means and methods in which a person's life. We all know the one with the stars and the moon and the movement and the prediction that death could come if Shani Devi was unhappy with you. We know if Shukra, the planet Venus, is not in your good house, in your marriage, you're going to have a lot of problem. That a woman could undergo polycystic ovary, swollen ovary, because of the effect of the planet Venus. That a person becomes an addict to alcohol, cigarette and other vices when Mangla or Mars is not in your book. It is from this part of that text we have the science. There's also the part that says if a person's body, remember the other night we were talking about the signs upon a person's body, reflecting who you are and who you will be in your previous life. Listen a little more about that. There is a study of mold, what we call mold, little blemish upon the body, black dot. And when a person has a mold over the right eye, the left eye, the ear, on the chest, the finger, the breast, the hip, the knee, which toe, it has particular significance, whether it will be a weakness for the person or a strength for the person. Has weakness in eyesight, etc. It says it gives a message about who you are and trouble that you may have. Then there's the practice of knowing where you're born, the nakshatra or the star that is governing where you are born, what type of life you live. For example, for people that are born under Dhanu Rashi, for example, people that have the Rasi name like Yoman, Yaman, Y-O-Y-A, E-H-A, etc., B-H-A, etc. When you are born under the gross Rasi name, the Rasi name is just a person. What does it mean? It means that within your body there are certain strength, the person will be a wonderful journalist, best writer, best reader, literature will be a strength. Who's mathematician has to be good? Weakest point is mass. But this person, within their body, they have the power of speech. But within your body as well, your lung is your weakness. Within each person's body, there's a weak point. And you check people that have similar Rasi. And you'll see all of them that are born under Dhanush Rasi have asthma, lung infection, or some lung related problem. So when you know your Rasi, you know, you can see where your health problems will come, and you can safeguard against. Then come, according to Parashuni, the practice of reading your palm. Some people read the print of under the feet. How do you read your palm? You don't watch anybody who holding your hand like this and reading your palm. That's not the correct thing. You're supposed to print it so that you can watch very clearly lines. The thickness of the line, the length of the line, etc. Bharat Muni did one thing. He did a book that is a patra that goes back for. Have you ever heard of the patra that deals with your past life? There is such a book, and it was written by these two fellows. And the reason that you don't RT a patra book is simply because of the fact that Lakshmi Mata did not endorse it. This is why it is so. Parashat Muni was in the middle of writing that section that deals with the marks, the type of pause that a baby or a person would have. When a father-in-law and mother-in-law looks at a girl that is going to get married, and you know, we mentioned earlier in the person who has the birth week here, this is along the lines what I'm talking about. You know, long time ago when they saw a girl had this mark here, it was an indication that she would lose her husband within the marriage. Similar to what we say when we see the second toe a little longer than the first toe, the big toe. And they say the girl is going to rule within the marriage. Along that line, there are other signs. If you have two strands of hair going in one paw, look at your body, you'll see it. Or three strands of hair coming out of one paw, there's a message associated with both. And he was listening as Ganesh Baba was giving him advice as he was writing. He knew the science of Ganesh Baba had the way of putting it out. He knew the language and the art of writing it down. And as this holy conversation was taking place, Kramcha comes to interfere. He comes to disrupt this conversation. But Parashat Muni doesn't ask Ganapati Baba for help. He gets up as he is the head of the ashram to see what is the problem. And he runs outside and let's see what happens. Everybody, let's sing together. He's very aware of all the people around him. He's uncomfortable. He's eating in a greedy manner. But he's very focused on the fact that different people are coming up close to him. And he will swing his huge tail and knock them off. And when the mother of the ashram, the spouse of Parashamuni, Devi Vatsal, comes close to him out, she's fearless because she's thinking this rat is going to eat all the food. And what about her children? So she goes close to Kramcha. This huge rat, as he's devouring, swallowing, he's not chewing. He's, if he could drink it, he would drink. He's pulling his mouth more than he can take. And Devi Vatsal goes with a stick and she tries to poke him. Go, you beast, go from here. Leave my children's food. And without thinking, the tailor comes and hit her. And she gets under from the rubble as he got into the different buildings in the ashram. She gets knocked on and under, onto and then under some of the rubble. And as she calls for help, Ganesh Baba, he sees her and comes out. And Ganapati Baba runs down and says, Ma, let me help you, mother. And with the bruise and the cut and the blood and bleeding from that injury, this older body that has become very frail now due to injury, he picks her up and he takes her to safety. And the mother speaks this to Ganesh Baba. That I have been feeding all these children in the ashram of Parashadmani. Ganesh was son of Girija, was son of Parvati. I had many children. Many children that promised to take care of me. Many children that pledged their support, pledged pleasure and all. But son, when this demon appeared, when this ferocious animal appeared, I was abandoned. And those that had younger feet, they fled. I couldn't fled. I couldn't flee. I couldn't leave the food of my children. I was thinking about them. And as a result, I got damaged. But look at me now, son. All the children I have, and they are alone. Ganesh, you are not my biological son, but you are my savior. She said, pitiful are some mothers that have children that are never children. Pitiful are some mothers that cry to have the love of their children and never have the love of their children. Ganesh, I never fed you. As a mother, I never fed you. I did not contribute to your growth, nor to your knowledge, nor to your respect, none of your traits. I didn't give any of that.